Vandaag heet ik iedereen welkom die naar de dagelijkse devotie luistert. Welcome to the Leeward Island District Devotional for today. I am Tishona Petronia of the Rotterdam Congregation in the Holland Circuit. I hope that we will receive the message and pray, take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. My focus today is, take my will and make it thine. It shall be no longer mine. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we are grateful for today that you have given us another day of life. God, you are so good, your creation is beautiful, and you gave it for us to enjoy. We want to say that we love you for your goodness. We thank you for your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you for sending your Holy Spirit to live in us and to guide us. We praise you for your great love. We want to live in such a way that shows that we love you too. We want to be kind and loving towards others. Help us to live today with the confidence that you are near us. Give us the courage to live for you today and every day. Amen. Today our verse from scripture is taken from the gospel according to Luke chapter 22. Jesus had a difficult decision to make. Would he die for you and me and everybody? That was a hard choice for him, but that was the Father's will. He prayed in verse 42, Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done. Your will is what you really want to do. It is how you have made up your mind. When you have made up your mind, it is difficult to get someone to change it. You go about your business and you do exactly what you have made up your mind to do. So then, can we really give up our will and just do what God wills? I don't think that that is easy, because Jesus seemed to have a struggle doing that. But I know from what I have been taught that it is best we do what God wants for us. So, I encourage us to pray that prayer. Take my will and make it thine. It takes courage because nobody wants to give someone else control over them, not even God. But when we come to see that God loves us perfectly, it is easier to trust God. The Lord wants only the very best for us. God's will is not going to be something that will turn out to be bad later on. People do things that seem nice and later on they regret it. Even me, at my age, I have said or done things, and sometime later on, I wish I had said something different or done something differently. My elders tell me that it's best to trust God's will instead of mine. They say that things will turn out for the best. I think that they are right, but it is still not the easiest thing to let God be in control. It may not be the easiest, but it's always the best way. So I will try my best to do God's will. Will you also try to do the same? Heavenly Father, we know that you want the very best for us. We know that you love us completely. We know that if we do your will, we will not go wrong. Teach us to do your will. Help us to want to do what pleases you. Make our lives beautiful, we pray. As we practice letting you take control of us, we can do this if we see that your will is always the best. And we will still be in charge, since it is up to us to remake the decision, to trust you to guide us in all we say and do. We pray. Take my will and make it thine. It shall be no longer mine. Amen.